Houston first met Robert Garner in 1993, when a young boy named Bobby was featured on KPRC-TV as part of a segment on Big Brothers Big Sisters of Houston. Bobby wanted a father figure he could look up to.
What kind of big brother do you want?
I put on the list, I want one with a hairy chest and big hands.
Even at that early age, Robert knew he had a calling.
Bobby always wanted to be a firefighter when he was a kid.
After graduating from Scarborough High School in Northwest Houston, Robert joined the Air Force, serving two tours of duty in Iraq. Eventually, he came back home to Houston and worked hard to get accepted into the Houston Fire Academy. He graduated and reported to Station 68 as a probationary firefighter.
It was one of the happiest days of his life.
Robert's coworkers say he focused on earning the respect of his more senior colleagues. Next came a promotion to the full rank of firefighter. Robert quickly became a respected member of the crew and a great friend.
He was an upstanding guy from start to finish.
Robert took his duties at Station 68 seriously, whether it was on the scene of a fire or inside the firehouse.
He called me and he said, they told me when I get to the fire station, I have to cook. It's not optional. And I said, okay, that seems reasonable. And he goes, I can't cook. So he used to come over once a week so I could try and teach him how to cook something. And I set him to chop an onion. I gave him the onion, I gave him the cutting board and a knife. And then I just heard bam, 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 bam as he whacked away and there was just onion flying all over the kitchen. It was the worst thing I've ever seen.
He made people laugh all the time.
Everybody wanted to be friends and hang out with him.
May 31st is that day that will always be the worst day in the Houston Fire Department's history. On that day, I witnessed more acts of courage and bravery and heroism than probably ever witnessed in my career.
Houston lost four heroes that day. Ann Sullivan, Robert Beebe, Matthew Renaud, and Robert Garner.
To have somebody that was such a part of your life be suddenly gone, and the circumstances were so sudden and so shocking. The truth is, it's a dangerous job, and no matter how good you are at it, it happens sometimes.
That night, as the men and women of the Houston Fire Department mourned their loss, the Robert Garner Foundation was born. One of Robert's best friends, Quincy Wade, reached out to Robert's family.
He said, you know, you don't really know me, but I was a friend of your brother's, and we sort of scheduled this gumbo cook-off to raise some money for some scholarships, and I should have called you and asked if that was okay. Of course that's okay, that's great.
The goal was to raise about $6,000 to pay for two scholarships designed to help educate and train future Houston firefighters. Houston's Carbach Brewery got involved.
We started off donating a very small amount of beer to help a little cook-off.
From there, things only got bigger.
We all came together and created this pub crawl, which generated, it just totally blew our goal away, so we decided to do it again.
The pub crawls raised well over $50,000, but that was just the beginning. There's now a special Carbach craft beer honoring the Fallen Four. It's called Station 68. Featured right now at fundraising events for the foundation, the goal is to eventually can it and sell it at retail stores across the city, with proceeds benefiting the foundation.
Carbach Brewing Company is going to give back in a big way for 2015. With that, our organization is looking to raise well over $300,000 for the Robert Garner Firefighter Foundation.
Carbach was also a sponsor for the first annual Robert Garner Charity Golf Tournament at the Golf Club of Houston. And that money is already going to work in the community.
The core of what we do is right here in this classroom.
The foundation recently presented textbooks to Houston's High School for Law Enforcement and Criminal Justice. The books will go to students in a special fire science program who before now had to pay for these special textbooks on their own.
It's very important to support an organization that supports education for the fire service. The fire service has long been in the past a blue-collar trade, and it's now a profession.
The foundation also has big plans for scholarships to aid deserving students enrolled in Fort Bend ISD, Lone Star College, and Houston Community College.
This foundation supporting education increases the professionalism of our fire service.
Once a firefighter joins the ranks, he or she will benefit from programs supported by the Robert Garner Firefighter Foundation to help them advance their career. The foundation will cover the cost of written guidelines that firefighters must purchase before they can be promoted.
We believe that the fire service is a calling that people have, and we want to make that a reality for them. And it would be completely impossible without the support that we have received from sponsors, from the community, from the fire department, who believe in what we're doing.
And that is why all of you are gathered here tonight.
Being the gala chair is a great honor. It's been a great opportunity for me to work so closely with the foundation and the board on the foundation. They have done a fantastic job.
City leaders, family members, generous sponsors, members of the Houston Fire Department, and the citizens of Houston have all come together to continue Robert Garner's legacy of public service.
It's blown me away the way so many people have come together.
Within the first year of its existence, the Robert Garner Firefighter Foundation is on track to raise $1 million. It's become one of the fastest growing nonprofits in the United States.
This foundation supports an extremely good cause.
We can raise a glass, we can remember, and we can celebrate, and we can move forward to change the community and help the community each and every day.
We're so grateful. We're so grateful for all of the support that we've received. We have big plans and big dreams, and we want to change people's lives.